The vastness of space stretched endlessly before the crew of the Intrepid, their vessel now a splintered wreck amidst the dense canopy of Commodora. Once a coveted target for prospectors enticed by false mineral deposits, Commodora was a jungle death world renowned for its lethal inhabitants and treacherous terrain. Now, the ship lay crippled, its systems failing, leaving a small group of humans stranded on its surface. Captain Maya Reynolds surveyed the wreckage, her sharp eyes taking in the mangled hull and smoke billowing from the control panels. "Status report," she demanded, her voice steady despite the chaos. Lieutenant Aiden Carter, the ship's engineer, grimaced as he worked to salvage what he could. "Propulsion offline. Life support is compromised. Communications are down. We're not getting off this planet anytime soon." Sergeant Elena Morales, the team's security lead, checked her gear, ensuring her weapons were ready. "We need to set up a perimeter, establish a base, and figure out how to survive until we can get rescued." As the team began to work, little did they know they were not alone. The Varanidae, a formidable bipedal reptilian species, watched from the shadows. Standing 6 feet tall with sleek, green-scaled skin, their eyes gleamed with predatory intelligence. Their toxic saliva, a potent enzyme that prevented blood from coagulating, made them fearsome hunters. Commodora was their hunting ground, a place where they orchestrated elaborate traps to lure unsuspecting prey. Deep within the underbrush, Kazar, a seasoned Varanidae hunter, observed the humans with keen interest. Their crash had triggered the planet's intricate defense mechanisms, but the real prize was the opportunity to hunt evolved beings from another world. "We have fresh game," Kazar hissed to his pack. "Humans, let us begin the hunt." The Varanidae were masters of their domain, using false readings of rich mineral deposits to attract other species. Once a vessel landed, their traps would disable propulsion systems, rendering the occupants vulnerable. From there, the hunt was methodical and brutal. As night fell, the humans struggled to set up their base, unaware of the silent predators stalking them. Maya, focused on salvaging the ship, didn't notice the subtle movements in the periphery until a sharp pain lanced through her arm. She looked down to see a bite mark, her blood unable to clot as the Varanidae's saliva took effect. "Elena, I'm hit," Maya cried, her vision blurring as the toxin spread. Elena reacted swiftly, pulling Maya away and tending to her wound with the limited medical supplies they had. "We need to move. They're hunting us." The realization that they were targets changed the dynamics of the group. Survival became paramount, and the humans had to adapt quickly to outsmart their alien hunters. "We need to understand their patterns," Maya said, her determination unwavering despite the pain. "If we can anticipate their movements, we can set our own traps." Aiden worked tirelessly to repair their communication systems, hoping to send a distress signal. Meanwhile, Elena took charge of security, organizing patrols and establishing lookout points. As days turned into weeks, the humans learned to navigate the perilous jungle, using their wits and ingenuity to counter the Varanidae's tactics. They discovered that the Varanidae relied heavily on their toxic saliva to incapacitate prey, making it crucial to avoid close combat. Instead, they focused on setting traps and using guerrilla tactics to gain the upper hand. One evening, as the team gathered to review their progress, a plan began to take shape. They had observed that the Varanidae used specific markers to signal traps and coordinate hunts. If they could reverse engineer these signals, they could lead the predators into their own traps. "We need to turn their methods against them," Maya proposed. "If we can control the environment, we can make them our prey." The team set to work, using salvaged parts from the Intrepid to create devices that mimicked the Varanidae's signals. They baited traps with false mineral readings, guiding the hunters into prepared kill zones. The first test was a tense encounter. A group of Varanidae, led by Kazar, followed the bait into a clearing where the humans had set explosive charges and noisemakers. As the predators stepped into the trap, the humans triggered the devices, disorienting and incapacitating their hunters. "Elena, on guard," Maya ordered, as the humans moved swiftly to secure the area. Kazar, recovering from the initial shock, realized too late that he had been led into a human trap. Blood gushed from his wounds, unable to clot, and he staggered, his strength waning. With their hunters momentarily subdued, the humans gained a significant advantage. They knew they had to act quickly before the Varanidae could regroup. Using the compromised communication systems, they sent out a distress signal, hoping for rescue. As they prepared for the final confrontation, tensions ran high. Elena, now partially immune to the toxin thanks to rapid treatment, took the lead in strategizing their next move. "We need to eliminate their leadership," Maya suggested. "Without Kazar, their coordination will crumble." The humans set a final trap in the heart of the jungle, where Kazar was likely to pass through. Using a combination of noise, light, and false mineral readings, they lured the Varanidae leader into a controlled environment. The trap was elaborate, designed to neutralize Kazar without direct confrontation. As he entered the clearing, the humans activated the devices, releasing a cloud of sedative gas mixed with an enzyme inhibitor that counteracted his toxic saliva. Kazar stumbled, disoriented and weakened. Elena stepped forward, her weapon trained on him. "It's over, Kazar. You're not going to hunt us anymore." Realizing the futility of his situation, Kazar lowered his head, acknowledging defeat. The remaining Varanidae, witnessing their leader's downfall, retreated into the depths of Commodora, their hunting grounds no longer their domain. With the immediate threat neutralized, the humans focused on repairing their ship. Aiden worked tirelessly, utilizing scavenged parts and innovative solutions to bring the Intrepid back online. Days of hard work paid off as the ship's systems gradually returned to functionality. As the humans prepared to leave Commodora, they took a moment to reflect on their ordeal. They had entered as prey and emerged as hunters, proving humanity's resistance and malleability in the face of overwhelming odds. "We did it," Maya said, a hint of pride in her voice. "We turned the tables and survived." Elena nodded, her eyes scanning the jungle one last time. "Let's hope no one else falls into their trap." The Intrepid lifted off, leaving the treacherous jungle behind. As they ascended into space, the humans looked back at Commodora, a silent testament to their struggle and triumph. Back among the stars, the story of the Intrepid crew's survival on Commodora became a legend, a testament to human ingenuity and perseverance. It served as a reminder that even in the darkest corners of the galaxy, humanity would not only survive but thrive, adapting and overcoming challenges that threatened their existence. The tale of how humans turned the hunters into the hunted spread across the galaxy, inspiring others to believe in their own resilience. It was a story of hope, courage, and the unyielding temperament that defines humanity. In the end, the crew of the Intrepid had not only survived Commodora, but had also proven that humanity could adapt, learn, and overcome any obstacle. They had faced their fears, outsmarted a formidable alien race, and emerged victorious, a true testament to the invincible human spirit.